Commander CSI, commanding in the 21st century under high tension Pentecostal power anointing, licensed to liberate mankind and devastate the kingdom of darkness. Whatever place you are, they call me prophetic mathematician, and others call me the talking spirit. I want to use this opportunity to talk to some of us, but I don't want no offense on this talk. I just feel like I need to talk. No, just to advise some of us that met me up and some people that always come to my office. And when they come to the office, they always said something very striking. You know, as the year just started and everything is just on the other way. And some people call me. They say, man of God, you know, everywhere is locked down and I'm lonely and I'm lonely and I'm lonely. Every one of them, I'm lonely. Man of God, pray for me. What will I pray for you? I need a companion. I need somebody in my life. And you know what? There is no disrespect about this. 80% of them happen to be women. And I happen to have daughters. And for that purpose, I want to address some of these issues so that we can't just be hammering on one thing and all that. So quickly, I asked one of them, what actually do you want? He said, I'm lonely. I just need a companion. And I say to you, and that is why I want to talk to each and every one of us. When you are in company of this man, what will you be doing? When God sent you that heart, your heart desire, what will you be doing with him? Sex. Baby, do it. Baby, have her. Baby, I'm coming. Baby, make me come. And you are screaming and all that. And after that, what next? All these things you are doing is just 1 hour. You are done. 24 hours. What will you be doing? What will you put down in the table? Before you look for company, before you look for somebody to sleep with, to scream with, you need to first of all found yourself. Who are you? Because it's what you get from yourself that is what you offer. Have you asked yourself, if I get a boyfriend now, if I got a husband now, what will I give the man? It's just sex. It's only sex. Is sex will only what you can give the man that you want to be companion with? I want to just specify on these ladies, because you are the ones that just are carrying it as if you are in roti and double joint. And that is why I'm asking you, what do you intend to be companion with this person when you are finally married to him? That is when the marriage get tiring. That is where the marriage get. That's why the marriage get frustrated, and that is why the man dumps you, because you say you want to give love, but you don't love yourself. So how do you want to give the love if you don't have love? Before you can give anybody love, you must love yourself so much. Before you must bring company, you must be so comfortable. You know, that is why I don't allow people to come to my space, because I need to love myself and all that before I can bring you to my space, to bring you to come and scatter the bed and the toilet and scatter soap everywhere. Is that all you can offer? I'm not talking about physical cash. I'm talking about the company you want to give him. When you mean company, company simply means keeping somebody busy, keeping somebody active. What will you be discussing? After the first round of sex, second round of sex, what next can you give the man? What else can the man give to you? Marriage, what you are going to do in marriage is talk, is companionship, is talking more than the way you have sex. I'm sorry that I talk this way. But talking is more what you need more, not sex. Sex key is 1%. But talking is what goes on and on and on and on and on and on. That is what marriage is all about. Sometimes people don't have anything to talk about. And the only time you have time to talk about it, the only time you have, you need experience is what you are building on yourself when you don't have a man, self-discovery. And when you get it, that is what you will now talk to the man, your boyfriend, your husband, your aspiration, what you are doing, what you do when you were single and all that. But yourself, you can't even answer the question because you don't even know yourself. Discover yourself before you can begin to get somebody. I'm waiting for you now. Talk to me. You want man? Mrs. Man. That is all you want? It's not to have the man that matters, is to keep the man. And that is why some of you will get the man and the man will go. Some of you will get the woman will still go. Because you spend your time wanting to have, but you don't spend time to know how to keep the man. There is nothing you want to get in this life that you will not get, but how to maintain it. Because everybody needs maintenance. Because we spend more time wanting to get is to maintain it. Now, let me tell you this. Just like I have my beers, it's not easy to have beers. People can have beers, but how you maintain it makes you look neat or bad. Some of you, you have all it takes, yeah, but can you maintain it? If you can't maintain it, how do you want a man to maintain it for you? It's not hard to get up to a ladder that matters. It's hard to remain there. It's not hard to be rich. It's hard to be wealthy. Wealth is different from riches. Everybody can be rich, but not everybody can be wealthy. Rich is when you get this shirt, but wealth is when you have the factory where you are manufacturing this dress, this shirt I'm wearing. The struggle is to remain there, not to get it. Not everybody that touch money is a millionaire. When you eat your money, when you spend your money, you are not a millionaire. Millionaires are still those that are still there. Billionaires are still those that are still there, not those that have finished their own. You that are looking for husband, looking for man. Ask yourself, if this man come, what will I give to this man? You will have sex until you get tired. And sometimes sex get tiring, you know. It's not all about sex. Some of you are entering into sex because you are all only what you want is just go there, sex in the morning, sex in the afternoon. It gets tiring, you know. It will come to a point when the man will even come. You'll be running away. You don't want the sex anymore. But this is sex now. Okay, continue with sex. This is sex because you have nothing again to offer and you are running. Haven't you seen where married women are saying, I don't need anymore, I don't want to fuck anymore, I don't want to have sex anymore. And the man is saying, but this is yours. And you say, but listen to me. Because you say you are not in the mood. When the man said, come, you say you are not in the mood. Now, you are not in the mood. Now, you must be in the mood. Companionship is the main reason why two people come together. Companionship is simply having something to share with one another. Sharing your aspiration, sharing your dream, sharing your vision, sharing your experience. This person is growing, you are growing, the person is growing. There is communication and revelation that comes in communication. And when you sit down and discuss, you get answer from anything you want. That is what marriage is all about. When children come, communication continues. You don't need to start, you yourself need to start dreaming for the children before the children will start having dream for themselves. But many of us today, you don't even have dream for yourself. How can you have dream for your children? That is why you have a lot of single mothers running around looking for a man to come and pay child support. Because you don't have dream for that child. If you have dream for that child before the child comes, I tell you, when you have dream for that child will go and fit in that dream. You don't need no man for no man child support. Today, all over the country, child support. I lock her up. Is that all? All those things happen because there was no plan, no conversation, no discussion. I feel, you see, sex is not the key. It's not just all you need. You need to take care of yourself. Redirect your mindset. Try to discover yourself. Self-discovery. Self-discovery is what matters. Start to love your company. The time you know that you are free in life is the time you can sleep by yourself and you are so happy. You don't need to have people around you to be happy. You have gotten freedom. Stay by yourself. Listen to me. I am on my own company. I can be in this room and I dance and I jump around and I talk the way I want. I can put no meat. Why? Because I am my own entertainment. I can watch myself and I laugh. I can even finish doing this video and I will sit and say, wow, Commander CSI, you did it. I laugh. I love my company. You understand? And the only time I can do this kind of video is only when I'm by myself. Because if I have somebody around me, that person may distract me. I have achieved a lot of things on my own when I'm by myself. I don't know why you are running away from yourself. Are you that ugly that yourself is carrying you and you don't want to stay with yourself? Every time you are with yourself, you are saying you are lonely, you are tired, you don't like yourself. If yourself is scaring you, why wouldn't you scare another person? If you cannot stay by yourself, how do you want somebody to stay with you? How do you want somebody to stay with you? I'm asking you. That means you are wicked because you can't stay with yourself. You can't stay by yourself. Oh my God. Be relaxed with yourself, whether you are tall, whether you are small, whether you are fat, whether you have a big breast or whatever. The way you treat yourself is the way people will treat you. When people come, listen to me now, when a man come to meet you and see that you are using iPhone, they will not buy you Samsung. When a man come to you and discover you can fix you can buy your Brazilian hair or your Indian hair or even your goat hair, I don't know, and maybe 25 inches, 45 inches, 60 inches hair, the man will value you. Knowing you cannot even buy synthetic hair, grass hair, and now a man come, you want him to go and buy you Brazilian hair or Indian hair or China hair. And now you are using Tecno. And now you want the man to buy you iPhone 10 or iPhone 11. Listen to me. I just feel tired sometimes. When you have your own Indian hair, Brazilian hair, you buy. And you buy it for $600, $7,000, $6,000, or for $300. Or $2,000, and you get it, and you are maintaining it. The man will know that you can maintain it. But some of you today, you gathering wealth and squashing it, you can never be a rich person. I just want to talk to some of our young girls. Please be happy for yourself. What can you offer to the man that you needed so badly in your life? I want to put something on your head. I don't think I'm confusing you, but I want to encourage you. Before you want that man, have something to offer them. Before you know it now, everybody tarry night, everybody all night, they come to me, man of God, do you have any oil that I can just use? I need a man. You are looking for a man the way a monkey is looking for banana. And when you give monkey banana, he just, and just eat it. And the monkey look for more banana. That is the way you people are behaving. You looking for man. Man come, what do you do with the man? You have a nasty character, nasty attitude. I'm sorry that I'm talking this way. Please, I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I'm talking this way. Have self-esteem. Know yourself. Discover yourself before you can go forward in life. I just want to make a common sense today. And I believe that I've never offended anybody through this video. But I'm tired when people are always looking for man, the way monkey look for banana everywhere. Value yourself. If you don't value yourself, nobody will value you. Love yourself. If you don't love yourself, nobody will love you. Don't always say, I am lonely. If you can't love yourself in your lonely state, this video I am doing now, I will not just be doing this video. If I'm have people here, they will distract me. But I'm doing this video because I'm alone here. What you do when you are alone determine what will come out when you are with somebody. Love yourself, ladies. Men, I'm coming for you. You men, I am coming for you. But ladies, please love yourself. My name is Commander CSI, commanding in the 21st century under high tension Pentecostal power anointing. From me to you today, I want to say to you, Maranatha, remain in the house of Tatagrammaton. Gracias.